say about Bon Jovi's next video, Breakout.
I want to show what the band is about, you know, what John Bon Jovi is about, and take it backstage, take it to the bus, show you what a concert's really like, you know, let you know what the American tour was all about. And it's a thank you from us to the kids for supporting us this year, you know, with our first album.
Well, we just saw the American tour with the Scorpions, but right now, lead singer John Bon Jovi says we'll have to wait for their second album.
As far as the new album's concerned, we're going to do the Japanese tour, come home for 3 weeks, and then we're doing our European tour with Kiss. So we're lucky enough that our first album is a world tour, and we're going to do all of Europe with Kiss and won't be back until mid-November. So I plan on having the album out the last week of January.
The TV, and just before it, John Bon Jovi, the second one to come from his album. Happens that John is here with us in the studio. And in just a couple of moments, we'll be talking a little bit about what life means to John. We are back and talking with John Bon Jovi.
Hey.
Second visit to MTV for John. He just came back. In fact, we were talking a little bit about you just coming back from Japan.
Yeah, still trying to wake up the jet lag.
A Jersey kid goes to Japan.
That's what it is.
How was it for you?
Oh, it was amazing. The kids are amazing, and they're in the era of the Beatles over there. Yeah, I mean, you know, when we would walk down the street, you'd really have to be incognito to get by, because there'd be 500 or 1,000 kids waiting outside the hotel every day. We had this little bodyguard, his name was Now. So you go, I need you now. He'd come running up. I don't know what he said to these kids, but he'd say something and they would like take a complete about face and walk away. Like, you know, he never raised his hands once, but you know the guy was evil. You know?
So they love Bon Jovi over there.
Yeah, fortunately, I'm glad somebody does besides my mother. We love you too, America.
Touring plans back here in the United States, do you have?
Well, you know, after the Scorpions tour, we did the entire U.S. tour with the Scorps, and then the Japanese thing. Now we're going to Europe next month. Yeah, it's going to be a long year. We're going to Europe with Kiss.
Uh-huh.
And I wouldn't imagine being back in the States, really, I mean, an extent of any kind of tour until next year.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's all that I'm figuring on right now, the Kiss tour and getting right back in the studio.
What we're going to do is break away for a minute and show some more video, but we'll come back and talk a little bit about some of your stuff. Some of your video.
All right.
All right. More with John Bon Jovi right now, Lena Lovitch. How would they say that in Japan?
Level low.
We're talking with John Bon Jovi tonight. We talked a little bit about your trip to Japan. What I didn't ask you last time around was about more video from the album that's out now. Is that a possibility?
Yeah. You know, I was able to judge the basement tapes just before I left, and I was talking about how we were going to do a video for Breakout. There's an edited version, which PolyGram is just getting together now. And it was going to be shot, and we were going to use the footage from the Scorpions tour. That's what it was, you know, shot backstage in the buses, you know, on the dressing room feel. And it was basically a thanks to the kids, you know, to our fans for helping us, you know, through the year.
Mm-hmm.
What we've decided now is possibly using the footage from the Japanese tour, which I don't think MTV's had anything like that before. Where, you know, you're going to see 20,000 kids in Japan and Bon Jovi live on stage daytime kind of thing, and that feel. So there's a question mark with it right now. You know, we want to see what to go with.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, like I said, we're just getting used to the time change, so I haven't been able to function until today, you know.
Well, we've talked about a lot of stuff that is pending. You're going to Europe to do some more dates.
Yeah, that starts in September.
Now, when do you find time to do another record?
Well, we get back on November the 6th, and I was informed by Mercury Records, thank you very much, on November 10th we start the album, you know. I said, when? They said the 10th. I said, oh, good, I hope I get over the jet lag quicker, you know.
What about, the jet lag is one thing, what about the tunes? You gotta...
They're there. No, yeah, I'm pretty happy with what we have, and I have 5 weeks to really nitpick now. Lance Quinn's going to produce again,
uh-huh.
And we'll be doing it, I believe, in Philadelphia. At a brand new studio called The Warehouse, which I'm pretty hip on. Lita Ford did her new record there.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to check that out, and starting there in November. While we're home for these 4.5 weeks, I want to go down there and lay some demos and see, because it's a brand new studio.
Yeah.
And Lance tells me it's good, so if it's not, you know.
So we're looking at, I guess a couple of months, 2-3 months beyond that, sometime early.
Yeah, 85. I'm figuring January of 85 it'll be out. That's what the band is looking at right now.
All right. Sounds good? John Bon Jovi. More video to come. Don't go anywhere. And keep your eyes on this guy.
In a world of...
to Europe next month for a four-week tour with Kiss. Now, as soon as they get back here, they'll head into the studio to record their second album.
Lance Quinn's going to produce again. Mm-hmm. And we'll be doing it, I believe, in Philadelphia at a brand new studio called The Warehouse, which I'm pretty hip on. Lita Ford did her new record there. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to check that out and start in there in November.
Watching the official. This next month, the proceeds of that show will go to a 16-year-old Bon Jovi fan who needs a liver transplant, as well as... And the proceeds will go to two healthcare organizations. Tickets have not gone on sale for that September 22nd show yet. Concert dates...
You judge for yourself. They want commuters going over the 59th Street Bridge to have something to look at while waiting in traffic, often notorious for having bumper-to-bumper traffic. So this studio called Silver Cup Studios, located in Queens, New York, is putting up a screen. They want to test a screen with five different panels, one for each country, classical, rock, Spanish, and moderate music to show videos that they have made. For instance, Bon Jovi made their video there. Each screen will also have a music simulcast on a local radio station. The city, understandably, is quite concerned over how the videos may distract drivers, but the studio says, how much harm can we do when traffic is already bumper to bumper? An appearance on Bon Jovi's record. I think John Bon Jovi is going to be on Aldo Nova's next record, both New Jersey natives. John Fogerty.
Terrible.
93 FM. Hit radio. Commercial free. In traffic, a collision on the Southwest Freeway.
Go ahead, Kyuzu. Make my day.
Stick that dear knife down.
93 FM. It takes a knocking. And keeps on rocking. Ooh, yeah!
Well, they go in November at the Warehouse Studio down in Philadelphia. Lance Quinn once again will be producing. Now, John Bon Jovi tells us that he's already written some songs for the album.
There's one called Only Lonely that I'm really happy with and think it could be a single. Danger Zone, Afraid of the Night, which is something that's really happening. There's a secret title, which is actually dedicated to another country, which I've been living up on the press of that thing. This is dedicated to you guys, and it's from a tour that we just come back from in Japan.
Scorpions, live Scorpions. Madonna, Christian, an actress, refused to even touch them, so the Scorpions were dropped into the shot by a member of the crew wearing thick leather gloves. Now, Alec John Such, bass guitarist for Bon Jovi, was on the set and apparently took such a liking to the bugs that he brought them home with him. The clip was directed by Mark.
Shadows lay out there to look at you. You know July's the last night.
Coleco.
You're waiting for the new album. You might have to wait just a little bit longer. The band suffered a setback recently while they were rehearsing for their next album when their rehearsal studio in Perth Amboy, New Jersey was burglarized. All of their instruments, including synths, two guitars, two basses, some amps, and mics, were stolen. In fact, the only piece of equipment left behind was the drum kit, because who uses acoustic drums anymore anyway? Bon Jovi's management are offering a cash reward of up to $2,500 for information leading to the recovery of Bon Jovi's instruments. If you have any information, call McGee Entertainment in New York City. MTV presents...
finished up work on a new album called Twitch, an album on which he plays all the instruments with the exception of the drums, and has some help from people like John Bon Jovi on it. At the top of 1048 is the name of Bon Jovi's next album. They chose that title because it is apparently the hottest that volcanic rock can get. It'll be released in April, and then the band heads to Japan and Europe for a two-month tour. Then Bon Jovi will return to the States for a nationwide tour that will last until late October. In about half an hour, we have concert date information.
Out of New Jersey, that is music from Bon Jovi, who has a new album called 7048. And I understand from our scientific person over here that 7048 Fahrenheit is actually the hottest temperature that volcanic rock can get, 7048 degrees. Hot rock from Bon Jovi. Eric, founder John, told us how the songs on this album reflect a new perspective.
Last album was a feeling of writing songs. I was writing a lot from the point of view of a kid in New Jersey who lived and was born and bred in New Jersey. You know, you're writing from only a limited background, whereas touring the world last year and fortunately with the success that we had, I'm writing from a much broader spectrum of, you know, storylines.
30 minutes.
Good. The 100 degrees Fahrenheit will be released on Thursday. The first single, Only Lonely, is out now, and the video was shot last weekend in John Bon Jovi's hometown of Sarahville, New Jersey. Jack Cole, who also directed Steve Perry's Oh Sherry, shot the clip, and John and his band are on tour in Japan right now, and they'll be back here to tour in June. And by the way, the album's title, for all you science buffs, refers to the approximate temperature at which rock melts in the center of a volcano. That's something you can use in Trivial Pursuit sometime. We have
this year. The new single from Bon Jovi has already started burning up the airwaves. It's called Only Lonely, and is off the band's newest album, 7800 degrees Fahrenheit. That, by the way, is the temperature which rock melts. Cute, huh? And on the heels of the album release, Bon Jovi has left for a tour of Japan.
And all U.S. tour... new video from Bon Jovi, first one from the latest album, 7800 degrees Fahrenheit. The video is directed by Jack Cole, who is also directed for Dennis DeYoung and Steve Perry. Right now, Bon Jovi in the middle of a sold-out tour of Japan, but they'll be back to play in the U.S. on midsummer. Concert date information, solo concert...
It is Only Lonely is the new video from Bon Jovi, the first clip off their latest LP, 7800 degrees Fahrenheit. Now that's hot. The video was directed by Jack Cole, who also has done clips for Steve Perry. While ago, when I looked at this, there was somebody else, but right now, Bon Jovi are in the midst of a sold-out tour of Japan, but they will be back to play America around midsummer. Right now, concert information.
To basics. A bedroom in New Jersey to write the songs for Bon Jovi's second album, 7800 degrees Fahrenheit.
Again, went back to the bedroom because that seems to be my magic room. You know, I close myself in my room and turn the stereo on or just pick up that little acoustic guitar. And the first album was written like that on a Panasonic $20 tape recorder and a broken acoustic guitar. And I said, well, this is definitely the way to do the second one.
Simple Minds had a number one Quinn at film studios. After their first album, Bon Jovi toured extensively throughout America, also through Europe and the Far East. John Bon Jovi told us that it was the European audiences in particular that inspired the band to push a little harder when they made their second album, 7800 degrees Fahrenheit.
To me, the European kids, when they spend the equivalent of $9 on a ticket, which was like maybe 6 or 7 pounds, that was a lot of money to them. That was like, you know, they couldn't do anything else for the rest of the week if they wanted to come to a show, you know? there's that desperation and that still that true belief in rock and roll there.
Yes, release their comeback.
Light up the charts with their new album, 7,800 degrees Fahrenheit. But they weren't expecting the building, which actually houses their record label, to catch on fire, which is exactly what happened a day after the album's release. Maybe it was because of their hot single, Only Lonely. Today's breaking...
The tour was 100 degrees Fahrenheit. The Bon Jovi album is keeping Bon Jovi pretty busy. Last week, the group did some TV appearances in Hollywood, and next week they'll be doing a few warm-up dates in the Midwest before they kick off a big American tour. But John Bon Jovi recently spoke to us here at MTV, and he talked about the inspiration behind some of the songs on the new LP.
Japan inspired a song called Tokyo Road, and instead of writing something that was almost a corny thank you or a real trite, you know, and hey, thanks for the gold record, and I'm glad that you chased us down the streets, and it's Beatlemania, you know, I said, well, this is wrong. Tokyo Road is, lyrically, is a bar, and it's somebody's memory. And in the hook where it says, take me back to Tokyo Road, it was a way for me to say thank you, you know, here's what we're doing. In and Out of Love was inspired, really, because of America. That's an American road song, you know. There's nothing like being on the road in America. Nothing can match that.
Well, Bon Jovi's next video is going to be In and Out of Love. Concert information now for...
From Bon Jovi. Bon Jovi heating up the airwaves with scorching rock. How much heat would it take to melt rock? 7,800 degrees Fahrenheit, the new album from Bon Jovi on Mercury Records cassettes and compact disc.
Available at all Kmart stores.
Bon Jovi says that Bon Jovi's latest album, 7,800 degrees Fahrenheit, 7,800 degrees Fahrenheit, is a message from youth to youth. John told MTV that he was inspired to deliver this message by the audiences that Bon Jovi recently encountered in Europe.
A show to see Kiss and us last year was £5. I thought this was like this amazing bargain. And talking to the kids and realizing then how hard it was to get work and what a concert really meant to them, because there wasn't MTV, there wasn't a way to find out, you know, who your bands are, and there's not rock and roll radio as we know it in America. So it's really like this raw energy that they're living off of magazines and seeing it live, you know?
Big Jagger. No.
You're not. Are you?
Yeah,
I could tell. You do a little raspberry beret there. You have an opinion on every subject?
Yes.
All right, I'll tell you the reason I ask you. Whenever you watch a contest, beauty contest, dance contest, talent contest, you say, how come that guy and that woman won, whatever. When we do the American Bandstand contest, you have no argument with anybody because you are the judge. It starts next week and you will pick the winner, so make sure you watch next week, all right? You'll do that. It's a promise. Now, let me tell you about these poor guys. Poor guys, ho, ho, ho. Since the last time they were here, they have traveled all over the world, Japan, Europe, the United States. I think they've had 2 or 3 days off since they were last here. We'll find out about their activities. Ladies and gentlemen, Bon Jovi.
Yeah.
like a chamber music again, yes. How do you maintain your sanity with that volume?
You
know, real, John, excuse me. Please introduce me to your friends first.
Richie Sambor on the guitar.
Hi, Richie, welcome aboard. On drums. Wait a minute, he's playing with the cameraman back there. What is this?
Yes. Seagull Torres on the drums.
Welcome back.
The veteran of bandstand.
The Daniel Bush. Boone here, yes, spy can. Where'd you get this? In Japan?
London.
Are you kidding?
I'm dead serious.
Looks like it came out of the old West. And lastly.
And David Bryan on the keyboard.
David, nice to have you with us. You told me a story when we were upstairs about the night you played, what, it was an English theater and the electricity went out?
Yeah, the Dominion Theater in London.
What do you do in a case like that? Light candles?
Well, you pray a little bit. You feel like Fred Flintstone, you know, you squat down a little
bit. How do you survive an ordeal like that?
Well, it's just the part that we play with our audience is it's like contact sport, okay? So they're so involved. When the PA went out for the second time in the same second song of the night, I ran off the stage and grabbed my acoustic guitar, ran back out. Everybody shut up real quiet, and I started playing Tom Petty songs, you know, and they all went, oh, okay.
I mean, there wasn't exactly what they were expecting,
no,
that's for sure. All right, now, you said you had 2 or 3 days off. What do you do when you get time off?
Mostly I take my motorcycle out, go up to the mountains, and stay there by myself.
You get away from these people?
Yeah.
Do you get along well?
Oh, we get along great, yeah.
He says, I hate you, man. I gotta get a microphone over there. We can start a fight right here.
National TV, man.
What happened this summer?
What happened? We're touring the States. And
June 15th.
June 15th, right?
15th? What's the air date of this show, Chris?
15th.
Somebody's looking at it. This is 15th. Where are you tonight?
Cleveland.
Cleveland, Ohio. All right. Have you been to Japan since that last time?
Yeah, well, we went in August, and we did what they called their first outdoor festival, baseball stadiums. And we went back this year on our own headlining tour, and we sold out 10 shows, and the album's platinum, and top 5 album over in Japan. So we've done 2 Japanese tours, went over to Europe, and just finished our European tour. Now we're ready to come back home and hit the stage.
Take a little time off after the U.S. tour. Gentlemen, thank you very much. Nice to have you back again. Ladies and gentlemen, Bon Jovi, thank you so much. We'll be right back.
And this week's number...
There's Van Halen, Quiet Riot, Twisted Sister, just to name a few. But this week's most popular heavy metal album is by our next guest. Their new LP has hit the top 20 on the charts only 4 weeks after it was released. Not bad. With their hot new single, Only Lonely, here's Bon Jovi.
Thank you.
Steve. And
be in England to play at the Castle Dunnington Festival with ZZ Top, Marillion, and Bon Jovi. Now here we have the Pretenders.
The film
was in the studio, and John, in fact, we were flipped out when we first heard the title of the album, 7800 degrees Fahrenheit. How did you happen to pick that?
Well, it's actually the guesstimation of the temperature at the center of a volcano, and I asked the professor at NYU, I said, well, why do you say it's a guesstimation? He says, nobody's crazy enough to go and find out for sure.
Nobody puts their hand on me to figure that out.
Well, the man gets paid like six digits for a guesstimation.
I understand that's the temperature at which rock melts. Right?
Yeah, so it's actually the center, and by that point, they say it's gas, it's gone, and you know, it doesn't get any hotter.
So actually, be careful if you put that new album
in
next to the rest of the album, so it melts everything around it. Right? Now, the album, we understand that you think, you say, is basically what the album means is a message from youth to youth.
Yeah.
What do you mean by that?
Well, touring Europe last year, you know, a lot of people don't know that we've been around the world now, you know, twice. And Europe is really where it hit me. But the idea where a pound to a kid, you know, like Americans, it means like a buck and a quarter. A show to see Kiss and Us last year was £5. I thought this was like this amazing bargain. And talking to the kids and realizing then how hard it was to get work and what a concert really meant to them, because there wasn't MTV, there wasn't a way to find out, you know, who your bands are, and there's not rock and roll radio as we know it in America. So it's really like this raw energy that they're living off of magazines and seeing it live, you know? So I'd hang out a lot of the times backstage and outside the shows and meet these kids and, you know, get them into the shows. And it affected the way I wrote the album.
And I think if you constantly do that, you know, as you go on and not lose touch with the audience, then you'll always be in tune.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. There's the basis of the band is really contact, you know?
One of the things I wanted to ask you about Only Lonely, when we first got the new video, it was hard to kind of explain what everybody was going to see, because it looks like a trailer to a movie that really doesn't exist. Tell me about how you came up with that
concept. Well, what happened was the director, Jack Cole, he talked to me about it, and he was really excited about the lyrics. And he says, you know, this could be a movie. And I said, oh, that's great. You know, so I would write lyrics that could be made into movies. He said, why don't we make a movie? And I said, well, now you're confusing me, you know, and it went over my head. We talked about it, and I took him to the club where the band first rehearsed at. I took him to the shore where we live. All the scenes are right in Jersey, right where the band is from. Those are all our friends in the video. So it's like a side of the band that you're really getting to know personally, where we're from and what we do.
And you think there may be a film stretched out of all of this?
There's been some offers of things and scenes, so I don't know.
Now what I want to do is we're going to play. Actually, we're going to set this up like they do on
big
TV. Only Lonely. All right. John Bon Jovi, 7800 degrees Fahrenheit is the album. Recently on American Bandstand.
Yeah, I ran into Amy and met all of them out there.
A good band out of Boston,
very
too.
Good,
and Only Lonely in front of that. Now, I wanted to know if you're going to do any more clips beyond Only Lonely.
Yeah, we're slated to start In and Out of Love on Monday out in Los Angeles before, and we head out.
You got any concepts you're thinking about as far as that's concerned?
It's got a real funny, interesting concept with this one. I'm not even going to leak it. It's actually real good.
Now, you're going to be touring this summer?
Yeah, it starts.
We're going to be able to see you here in
America,
the States.
I know, you're in Europe. The rest of the world is in already. Starting on the 12th of this month, we're going to headline for about 3 weeks, and then we'll team up with Rat on the 1st of July.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll be hitting your town.
Now, before you get away, because this is something I've always interested in, you know, on the sleeves of albums.
Uh-huh.
You know, you do a thank you to to Eddie Murphy.
Gunny Goo.
How did this come about?
The Delirious tape that he did for HBO is religiously viewed on our bus, you know, I mean, we know every line of it, and Eddie found out how we thanked him, and we're big fans, and so we went to the Radio City shows, which were sold out, and he heard that we were there and couldn't get in tickets and all, and set us up with tickets and passes, and we just sat there cheering him on. I'm one big Eddie Murphy fan, you know, we love him.
If you get a chance, I want you to watch MTV this week, but not because I'd like for you to watch all of the regulars, but Robert Wall's going to actually be a guest VJ, and he's a very funny man, and you've seen him on Carson and Letterman and
Merv
even, right? And even Hollywood Nights, you pointed out,
great
right?
Movie.
All right, so watch the beginning, and you've seen him in the beginning of Madonna's Material Girl. I loved him in that particular video.
So you're invited to spend a few fun-filled evenings with fill-in VJ Robert Wall,
and it's starting tonight, and actually, you know who's going to have with him, too, is Joe Piscopo, is that right? So that should be, speaking of Eddie Murphy, right, yeah. Good friend of, you know, is Joe Piscopo. All right, and that's immediately following Mark Goodman's Top 20 Countdown. It's a hot Friday. We've got John Bon Jovi dropped by. We had the bongos earlier.
All
we got
right.
Piscopo and Wall tonight. Hey, what more do you want out there, right?
MTV, we're in your home. Let's go. What time's dinner?
Thank you, John.
Continues with Bon Jovi.
USA.
The Heavy Metal Wednesday on Radio 1990. I'm Catherine Kinley.
And I'm John Bon Jovi, Catherine's co-host this week. I'm actually surprised to see that this place is still standing after last week's show at Wendy O. Williams and the Motley Crue.
So am I. What have you got planned for today, John?
Stay right where you are, because we're bringing you video music from AC/DC, Rat, and one of my favorites, Bon Jovi.
The fun's going to start with a man who is sharing his concert stage with an 18-foot fire-breathing dragon and two 8-foot knights, Ronnie James Dio, with Rock and Roll Children from his new LP, Sacred Heart.
That would be awesome.
Close to how you sound rock and roll.
Basically, I took a ride at the light and headed straight through the night, and I was on my own.
Oh, that's great. You should be a stand-up comic. What does your parents think
People
of your music?
At me all the time.
I won't laugh at you. I'll laugh at your jokes.
My parents like it a lot now. You know, I mean, they're real big fans now.
They're sold on you now.
Yeah, oh yeah. Now, you know, they're getting by. But I remember in the beginning, my parents said that they almost crawled under the seats in a high school talent
noisy.
Search contest. Yeah, I said, yeah.
You play that?
You should go to school, yeah.
Now it's time for our Hit Parader magazine Heavy Metal Hotline. We've got only one piece of news this week. John, it involves you.
Uh-huh.
It seems that during a recent show of yours in Dallas, Texas, a man and a woman actually got married on stage. The ceremony was done between Grim Reaper's set and yours before 80,000 fans.
Uh-huh. You know, I didn't know anything about this. Grim Reaper went on, and then, you know, as we were getting ready to go out there, I heard about a wedding that took place, and it was days later before I heard anything about it. I mean, the band didn't know. I know if Ted Nugent would have known, he went out and tried to marry him himself. You know? Certainly a piece of history, you know. Anybody who gets married to Tokyo Road, you know, I guess is okay with me. Anyhow, today's video pick is AC/DC, so you keep watch.
AC/DC hasn't released an album of new material in this country for 2 years.
But now they're out on tour, and soon they'll be releasing a home video consisting of 5 songs from the new LP, Fly on the Wall.
Think the Pink is the name of the second video from the record, and it's today's video pick on Radio 1990. Older heavy metal bands around, what band really influenced you?
A lot of bands that influenced me were The Animals, early on, Eric Burdon and that voice. You know, I think it's inspired me now later. Old Jeff Beck, Rod Stewart
records.
Yeah. Zeppelin, of course. Listening to a lot of singers, you know, I think that's really my background.
Here's a question for you. If you could put together an all-time great band, something that you would call a great band, who would you put in it?
Of course, you have to look to the singers. Again, Tina Turner, Jagger. Even if Mick couldn't sing, just to be strutting on the stage. Fred Flintstone on the drum.
Oh, plays good rock and roll, yeah.
The tour of Bedrock. I think it would end up being about 16 singers in the London Philharmonic.
I'll buy a ticket to see that show, I'll tell you. Mm-hmm. You know, you're really an idol to a lot of the kids today. What would you like them to remember you for?
My week as a co-host on Radio 1990.
No, you're wonderful. He's marvelous. He looks marvelous.
Better to look good than you.
We're going to take a look at the music that rocks Los Angeles next with Lisa Robinson. Music videos seem to have a sense of humor all their own.
It's sort of like the circus, you know, that's the way we have
really
to look
is.
At it. You know, that we're just an entertainment factor and we want to make people smile.
On a more personal level, how do you approach writing your songs, and what are some of your favorite subjects?
Not history and math, they left. Writing a song to me is like almost a religious experience. You know, I sit down and it could be anywhere in a car. It could be in my room in New Jersey. It could be right here. You know, if I had an idea, I would basically just look for a pen. If you didn't have it, I'd find your lipstick or something and start scribbling quick. But subject matter on this album had a lot to do with beating a struggle. And, you know, that's really where I was sitting at this year. And next year, who knows, you know? I mean, it's hard to say. You can't angle, you know, what, oh, next year I'm going to do this and then.
Yeah.
So it's all just naturally.
Well, we'll be back with a hot pick from John Bon Jovi.
Just go where you are.
John, let's say that there are actually some people out there who have never heard heavy metal music, never heard of John Bon Jovi. Now, what would you say to them?
Where have you been?
Well, at least for the last 2 years.
Yeah, that's good.
For those of you who don't know John Bon Jovi, you were once quoted as saying that your musical influences were more along the lines of Jimmy Cagney and Clint Eastwood, rather than the Beatles or the Rolling Stones. How is that? That's kind of hard to believe.
Well, basically, I like to call our songs detective songs, you know, and I sit down and do a lot of writing in this minor key where I put on the hat and the sunglasses, and it could be dark and I could be like locked up in a room somewhere, but that minor, A minor detective chord feel takes me, you know, into my own little fictional world. Someday, the walls are going to be rubber. I know it. I'm waiting for the, you know, the day where they come with the straitjacket and they say, try this one on.
So that's what heavy metal is all about.
Yeah. Welcome to the world of John Bon Jovi.
They are not nice people.
This week.
Tomorrow, Catherine and I will be back with the Pointer Sisters, Sheila E., and another one of my favorites from The Babies.
We'll see you then. Hi, I'm Catherine Kinley, and this is John Bon Jovi, my special co-host, all this week on Radio 1990. How you doing, John?
Oh, I'm great, Catherine.
Good, because today we're going to rock you with video music from...
The Pointer Sisters and one of my favorites, The Babies, Turn and Walk Away.
Let's kick off the music with a woman who takes along two bodyguards when she goes shopping for antique clothing in New York City.
It's Sheila E. It's me. No, it's Sheila E. with Sister Faith.
For one of your favorite video picks, who do we have today?
This is the one from The Babies, Turn and Walk Away.
The Pointer Sisters dare me on today's video pick.
So stay tuned to Radio 1990. I wanna take you
up! Last album produced hits with Neutron Dance, Jump, and I'm so excited.
I knew that song, Jump. Jump. The new LP is called Contact and is already high on the album chart.
Now, Scarface and Thief of Hearts actor Stephen Bauer and boxer Mark Freeland help out the sisters from Oakland with their new video, Dare Me. Just one example of the ever-increasing number of female singers around today. What do you think of the new crop of women singers that include people like Lone Justice, Katrina and the Waves, Madonna, Sheila E., Annie Lennox?
I think they're all great. You know, I mean, it's just more room for... more upcoming girls. I think the way that Janis Joplin and Benatar paved the way, you know, the avenue is wide open.
While we're on the subject of women, probably your favorite subject, how do you deal with all your screaming fans?
One by one.
Yeah, I bet you do.
Sometimes two.
Oh, we won't get into that. When Radio 1990 continues, the music of our nation's capital with Lisa Robinson. Now, what was that? You can tell me now. We're going to commercial.
I got this recorded radio from Shaw.
That's right. So you can be in a great musical mood no matter what you're listening to or where it's. Moving right along with all this fashion news, John. How important is fashion? Are you paying attention?
I'm listening to radio.
How important is fashion to hair, your image, your tours, your records, your whatever?
My designer, K-Mart, and I, K-Mart, he is a
French
designer.
Like
right out of the gutter and into your heart. That's been our slogan all year. You know, I mean, we're not a real image-conscious band, you know. My dad does my hair, and he's very, you know, I will get locked out of his house next time I go there if I don't make him. Otherwise, we are a product of blue jeans and sneakers.
Tomorrow, we're going to be back to Rock Your Friday with video music from Wham and Bon Jovi.
Now, wouldn't that make a triple bill, huh?
Plus, we'll go to the movies to see three films that are real creature features.
Godzilla, 1985, and two summer classics, Ghostbusters and Gremlins.
The three Gs. We'll see you then.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Let's groove some more.
Welcome to Radio 1990.
She's Catherine Kinlan.
And he's John Bon Jovi, my special co-host all this week.
For our last day together, our sad last day together, we have a music video from Bon Jovi and Spandau Ballet.
Plus, we'll take a trip to the movies to see the 3 G's. Gremlins, Ghostbusters,
and Godzilla, 1985. Friday's music starts with a band that just finished a 6-day tour of North America. Here's Wham with Freedom.
John, Bon Jovi is really popular in Japan, England, and in fact, most of Europe. Where is the farthest that you've ever gone for a concert?
Well, I think when my manager lost the card game, we had to go to Helsinki, Finland. And we were about 100 miles out of Russia. And they don't even have McDonald's there yet.
Oh, how sad.
It was a tough tragedy.
Now, every Friday, we answer a question from our mailbag. From McDonald's to mailbags. But first, what's the craziest question you've ever been asked by a fan? Not an interviewer, but a fan.
Well, it says right there, something rated PG, and this is a family show. So let's skip that question and move right along.
Okay, must have been a great question. Well, today's letter is from Deborah Ann Gurley from Mountain Grove, Missouri. She wants to know what Spandau Ballet is up to. Well, right now the group is rehearsing new materials.
We should be hearing a new single later this year, followed by the new LP in 1986. While we're waiting, here's Spandau Ballet in Hong Kong with Highly Strung.
Actually, for a while.
Actually, we were in Scotland and driving in a car, and Dave Bryan and myself were in the car with a girl from the record company who calls herself Kathy Andretti. And I didn't realize it until after we came over this hill. She slammed on the brakes, we hit into another car, and I had tendonitis in both my knees. So much for racing the streets of Scotland.
So much for that,
yeah,
boy.
Back home.
You find out somebody's last name before you go riding with them. Lisa Robinson's next with her report on the rappers of New York. The first rap band ever to perform on American Bandstand. Did you ever perform on the show?
Matter of fact, twice. The band and I were on Bandstand, and meeting Dick Clark, you know, is an American institution. When I met the man, I asked if I was supposed to kneel down and kiss his ring. And he just joked and immediately jumped down to his knee and kissed my ring, relieving all the tension. The man, what more can you say about him?
Yeah, but tell me, what does he look like? How does he look?
He looks
marvelous. Next, it's time to go to the movies for some creature features.
So you grab your popcorn, I'll grab Catherine, and we'll take you to see Godzilla 1985. Then two classics blast from the past. Again this summer is Gremlins and Ghostbusters.
Say, John and I have got 3 films that will chill you to the bone. The funny bone, that is.
The first is Godzilla 1985, in which everybody's favorite monster comes back.
Bon Jovi out of the gutter and into your heart with our latest video on Radio 1990.
Before we play our last video of the week, John, why don't you tell us what Bon Jovi's up to right now?
We are in the midst of the 7800 degree world tour. And it started in April in Japan, led us to Europe, and now to the hearts of America. We're going to stay here the rest of the year.
And after that, have any plans?
Vacation, sleep, eating.
Fun.
The good things like that, yeah. Looking for summer.
As most of our viewers know, you started in the business at the ripe old age of 16. What was your ultimate musical goal then, and what is it now? Has it changed?
I think at the time it was just the point of getting into the bars and not having to get proofed every time I walked in there, you know? They keep growing all the time. Of course, it went from playing an arena to playing a baseball stadium to playing, you know, the Cotton Bowl in Dallas. And now the idea of a gold album and then the platinum album, now that I'm spoiled, you know?
Let's take a look at John Bon Jovi and the rest of the band with She Don't Know Me.
That was She Don't Know Me off our first album. Recently, I said something in one of the fanzines about certain people in our videos and a little discriminatory. I'm really sorry, and when I do screw up, I want to make sure that I apologize to you guys because you're why I'm here. So anyhow, moving on to the better things.
The better things are, we've been having a great time this week, and I thank you for being here all this week with me.
Thank you, Jeff.
Next week, we've got a trio of co-hosts on Radio 1990.
On Monday and Tuesday, Catherine will be joined by video directors and musicians Godly and Cream. Catherine will then leave Godly and Cream on their own for Heavy Metal Wednesday. Tracy Ullman comes up later in the week with Catherine on Thursday and Friday.
To keep in the party mood this weekend,
Angel City live at Narara.
We've also got takeoffs to video directors and new sounds. So leave your TV set to this channel and Night Flight. Again, John, thanks for being here this week.
You're welcome.
It's been a real pleasure.
Thank you.
See you on Monday.
Jovi finally hit the world market. They said, where are you from? And we'd say, America. Because if you said you were from New Jersey, that kiss of death, it would be over, you know? People wouldn't even listen to your record. They'd say, oh, you sound like, no, we don't sound like them, you know? And, oh, you know, then you must sound like, no, we don't sound like them either, you know? Then after traveling around the world, you know, and going to Paris or London or Japan or Iowa, or, you know, or Los Angeles, you realize that you really appreciate where you're from, you know? And then all of a sudden I really became, you know, overseas a patriot, and in America a real Jerseyite, you know, and proud of that.
One thing we don't do is we don't drink and drive. It's not cool. It's not a way to make friends. If your friends are doing it, they're not your friends because they're going to be in trouble. If you guys are out drinking, at least keep one guy sober so he can drive you home. Just remember, you got to stay alive in 85 and don't drink and drive.
A public service message from U68 and John Bon Jovi.
In Inglewood, California. Celebrating a birthday today, Tova Felt.
Warn the bat, the
Hi, we're Bon Jovi.
You don't want to miss a minute of this week's MTV Top 20 Video Countdown. Stay right where you are.
Merle Haggard walked off and mocked.
This Tuesday night, 60 minutes of non-stop pop till you drop Bon Jovi Sweatshop. That's right, we are going to be your guest DJs. 10 o'clock Eastern, 9 Central, 7 Pacific. Be there.
Yeah.
Well, let's get all the people in the little camera.
Tonight, Bon Jovi Sweatshop. That's right, we are your guest DJs. 10 o'clock tonight, Eastern, 9, Central, 7, Pacific. Be there, or I'm coming to your house to get you.
What night?
John Bon Jovi videos they have planned for you. Now, we're sponsored by Sony Audio Tapes.
Playing some of our favorite stuff, but as usual, we're running late.
Where's Al?
I don't know where's Al. We're gonna be playing some stuff from Motley Crue, Rod Stewart, the Beatles, and of course, us. This is off the 7800 degrees Fahrenheit album. Give me a chance to get out of the shower. We'll be right in this one's called Silent Night. Tell Al to get out.
Gift for giving us a real job. Hi, we're Bon Jovi here in one piece.
Where's Al?
That was Silent Night off the 7800 Fahrenheit album. We're having a good time as your guest VJs. You're going to see a lot of different sides of these maniacs tonight right here in your living room. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you to the Professor Davis Amma Davis Bryan. Oh, no.
Remember that one? That's me. And this one, what's that? Hard Day's Night or something like that? The Fifth Beatle. I am the Fifth Beatle.
Little Richard.
That's me. Little Richard? Little Richard wasn't the Fifth Beatle. Listen.
Eddie Murphy.
It's been a hard day night, and I've been working like a dog. See, the Fifth Beatle is me. Listen, we'll be coming right back after this break with the Mop Heads and the Motley Crue. We love you, baby.
We're back here, and you're watching the Bon Jovi Guest VJ Hour.
Yeah, the rest of the guys are out looking for Alec.
Again. Yeah. I don't know where Al is. The boys be running around every which way. We got coming up Motley Crue and the Beatles, and Motley Crue and We know
you
this guy.
You know, Tommy Lee, my buddy. Very good. Yep. Good with glasses. Also, Tommy's got a nice show with the drums. He turns like this.
That's bad.
He looks at you. He's good.
He's bad and good at the same time.
I like him.
I like that.
First, we're going to have, like you said, the Beatles and A Hard Day's Night.
Coming to you right now.
All right, that was the latest one from the Motley Crue, filmed in Houston, Texas at the Summit.
Hey,
nice.
I'm on my way.
That was Home Sweet Home by Motley Crue. We're going to be back with a lot of fun on the Bon Jovi Roadrunner Video Hour.
Did you find Al yet, man? I can't
find him. No, don't tell
them.
We can't find Al.
Can't
we'll be back after this. I'm going to go look for Al.
See you later, man.
What's again? Formation.
All right, come on. Let's get it right. Okay, get in the team, motherfucker.
Hey,
come on.
Hi, I'm John Bon Jovi, and this is our guest VJ hour. Bon Jovi has taken over the studios of MTV, and we're hanging out in your living room. It's been 15 different countries, 60,000 miles, and these guys are tired. We've lost Dallas, our bass player. We're practicing now to be the Harlem Globetrotters. We're in the studio, working on a new album, and we're coming to your town soon, as long as I don't get hit here. Coming up, it's Pride from U2. Right now, Bono of the Edge and the rest of U2 are in the writing stages of the new album for that big follow-up to the Unforgettable Fire. Here's U2.
That was his video, Out of the Darkness.
Alex,
all right, man.
About
here's one from our friends, those bad boys running wild, the Scorpions with
Big City Nine.
Yeah. We love you, Klaus.
We love you, Klaus.
Breakers, don't you come around here no more. You know, they just released a double live album a few weeks ago called Pack Up the Plantation, recorded on the band's Southern Accent Tour.
Hey, John, I'm really starting to like doing this guest DJ stuff.
Yeah, it's all right.
What do you think, man?
We should live here.
We should get paid.
The Bon Jovi Wildman will be back in just a little bit.
Yep,
don't get lost.
This one's for you.
Where, oh, where are you tonight? Martha, you lead us here all alone. I came here with flowers. I came here to party. We came to MTV. You were gone.
Hang in there. Here's some Rod Stewart. Martha, this one's for you.
Tonight I'm yours.
Who knows where the cold wind blows? White Snake, love ain't no stranger. No stranger to us, these guys.
They're lovers from the Third Reich. Remember in Japan?
The first tour of Japan.
Yeah, drummers collective, a little bit of drinking, too much, a little bit of women, but a nice bunch of guys.
The only drummer I ever met that played in high heels and he had a toothpick in his teeth all the time. Cozy pal, great guy. We'll be back after this commercial with our own little bit of magic and a little bit of in and out of love.
Women, we had loved before. Who kicked us out and closed the door. Went in and out of love. The Lord was thinking of all the women we have loved before.
Hey, it's time to go. We've had a real good time as your guest VJs. 60 minutes of non-stop fun, Bon Jovi style. Make sure that you write lots of letters and tell everybody like Nina and Martha that we want to come back again because I want their job.
Come on back, y'all.
See you again. And Nina, why'd you open the door?
Nina, why'd you open that door?
Why? Bon Jovi will be our Friday night video fight contenders this Friday night at 10 p.m. Eastern Time. Next...
Friday night video fight, where the top videos go one-on-one tonight.
right, sports fans, last week in a premonition of Sunday's Super Bowl, the New England Patriots lost by a landslide in the Friday night video fight. 73% of your votes went to the new Super Bowl champs, the Chicago Bears. But hey, Jim McMahon, move over. Here comes the crew. Tonight's round of the Friday night video fights is sponsored in part by Strohs and Strohlite. And tonight we've got Motley Crue picking up the challenge as they go for 5 weeks on top. And it only takes 10 to hit the Video Fights Hall of Fame. Last time they took out Twisted Sister. This week they're being challenged by Bon Jovi, a group who in less than 3 years has found great success not only in this country but around the world. Their video is called Silent Night. Vince Neil signaling me that he is ready to begin, and he looks armed, dangerous. Here is the crew and Home Sweet Home. I'm Champs, Motley Crue, and Home Sweet Home from the Theater of Pain album. If Tommy Lee looks like he's smiling a little more than usual, could be very well because he's dating Heather Locklear from Dynasty, and what's not to smile about there. John Bon Jovi is busy adjusting his trunks while giving me the high sign, which can only mean one thing. He and the boys are ready to take on the crew. And here they are with Silent Night. Let the fight begin. There's John Bon Jovi and the band, brave challengers for tonight's Friday night video fight. Silent Night is the one. Well, you've seen our champs, you've seen the challengers, and how you're managing to keep yourself from rushing to the phones is anybody's guess. But hey, loosen up, let yourselves go, and call in your vote. You want to make Motley Crue a five-time winner tonight. 1-900-720-1501 for the crew. Bon Jovi. You want Bon Jovi to win, especially New Jersey. I know you're watching tonight. Here is the number, 1-900-720-1502. Time you think that I'd know better already, but every Friday night I bring two great bands together, and every week it never fails I get myself right in the middle of a video fight. Well, this week it's Bon Jovi's Silent Night up against Motley Crue's Home Sweet Home, which has won the last four times in a row. So once again, if you want to throw a punch for Motley Crue, 1-900-720-1501. Toss a punch for Bon Jovi by dialing 1-900-720-1502. Now, some very early returns are coming in already. Let's see what's happening so far. As I've said before, and I'll probably say again, the final outcome is always up to you. Go to the phones and let your will be done. Don't forget that these two bands competing tonight depend on your support. It's kind of like, look, it's like a Santa Claus thing. They know if you've been bad or good, and they know if you've been voting. So vote for goodness sake. Once again, here are the numbers as follows. Motley Crue, 1-900-720-1501. Or for Bon Jovi, dial 1-900-720-1502. Dial it up. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for, the voting requirements for this event, for this time and this time only. If you've ever had fun, or if you've had a friend who has had fun, you are eligible to vote tonight. Rush to your phone. You can vote in tonight's video fight. Here we are doing it for you on MTV. Let's have a look at how the fights are going so far. Let's take a look. Now, before your very eyes, the Wild Men of Motley Crue going for win number five here. Standing in their way, though, tonight and looking to start their own dynasty, the boys from Bon Jovi. Now, both Bon Jovi and most recently the crew have wrapped up successful tours of Japan, which, of course, is just a hop, skip, and a jump from here if you happen to be a Concord. Anyway, get your nerve up. Make the phone call. We're all friends here. The numbers. Dial for Motley Crue, 1-900-720-1501. Or for Bon Jovi, 1-900-720-1502. Following this bout, we've got the top 20 video countdown, but as they say in Japan, a first thing's first. We've had since last week's Super Bowl edition, huh? Come on, fun seekers. You want to make Motley Crue our five-time champs tonight, you dial 1-900-720-1501. To give the championship to Bon Jovi for win number one tonight, you dial 1-900-720-1502. Whew. The moment of truth approaches. First, though, don't be confused with the challenger in tonight. I, for one, can tell you that everybody here at the MTV studios, all the crew, is desperate to find out who you have chosen to win tonight. What do you say, crew, huh?
Yeah.
All right, hold on to your cameras, whatever else is handy. One more minute. I'm going to be back with those very same final results right after this.
Girls, hold it down, girls. You all know who this man is. Beard and all. We'll be talking to him in a couple minutes, so don't go away. All right, we're back here on Heavy Metal Mania with my guest, John Bon Jovi. So nice to have you here, my
pal.
Thanks, Dave. I didn't even recognize you with that beard. What's happening with that stuff?
I can't afford a razor after the tour, you know? They tuck it all packed up.
Oh, don't give me that, man. That last album you did went gold, 800,000 copies. It's still high on the charts.
Yeah.
I mean, I think you're going to hit platinum before this day is over.
Right,
I have a good feeling about that. Now, I know everybody wants to know what's happening with you right now. When's the new album coming out?
We're working on it right now. We just started rehearsing. We'll be in the studio mid-March in Vancouver, Canada, with a new producer, and hopefully it'll be out on the streets June.
You have any idea of title or anything like that?
Right now, it's Wanted, Dead or Alive. I think that's what the beard's for.
Aha!
Ooh. Yeah, the Clint Eastwood.
Very nice. Get the spurs or something like that. All right, I got a question. You know, I'm a big Kerrang! Magazine reader. That's that magazine in Britain. And they voted you, the readers, voted you male sex object of the year.
Oh,
now, I've never had that title myself. I was wondering what you felt about that.
I don't know. I guess, you know, it was between me and Sally Field. You know?
Actually, it was between you and Lemmy Kilmister.
Yeah, right.
Head, and it was a very close battle, but I think Stephen Piercy from Rat changed the tide. He called up
it.
And voted for you. Okay, we got the video. We got the Only Lonely video,
yeah.
And I was watching that thing. Great video. But to me, it seems like it's a movie trailer almost. Like you took excerpts from a film. You want to explain that video to our people before they see it?
Right. Here's the basic idea. I mean, you have a video and a song like Only Lonely, and when I had written it, the storyline in mind went along with this director's personal life, right? And he says, well, I can relate to this. He goes, these are great lyrics, we should make a movie. And I'm like two videos under my belt and go, great idea, we'll make a movie. Well, after I saw the movie, I wouldn't go to see it.
You mean it was a film?
No, he wanted to create such an idea that there was actually a movie to come.
Oh.
And see, you know, the lyrics created that sort of story.
But it definitely gave me the feeling like I was seeing a film and not a bad job of acting either. All right, let's check that video out right now. Bon Jovi, Only Lonely.
Iron Fist, and just so everybody knows, Lemmy came in fifth place on the Kerrang! Readers poll over the sex object of the year.
All right, people always writing to me asking why we don't have any hardcore thrash bands on Heavy Metal Mania. Well, pretty simply, there aren't any hardcore thrash videos out there. And the reason that's happening is because it just costs too much money for these bands to make a video, and they just don't get enough video airplay, plain and simply. But I am on the case, I am on the hunt for good hardcore thrash videos, and if I find some, you're going to see it. Now, speaking of hardcore metal, all right, check this out. If you got your own hardcore band, Combat Records, at Boot Camp Album Series, which will allow new metal bands the chance to get their demos onto vinyl with national distribution. And if you want more information on this, write to this address. All right! In a few minutes, I'm going to announce the lucky recruits in MTV's Twisted Invasion contest, so don't go away, and that's an order.
His very own American Twisted Sister maniacs are going to hang out with Dee Snider. No one with crew cuts allowed.
Absolutely not. We can't have crew cuts. I'd like to thank my good pal and bosom bestest friend and big toe,
East Coast
John Bon Jovi. That's right. East Coast Rat Pack. Jersey and New York right here. Hey, all you LA fans, come on, let's go. All right, this is the end of another exciting episode of Heavy Metal Mania. And until next time...
M-I-C-K-E-Y-N-A. M-A-N-I-A.
Yeah, right, Mania. Nighty-night, gang.
See you, kids. Speaking of boyfriends, Random Notes was very big on couples this year. We caught them tying the knot as well as biting the dust. This first photo of Julianne Phillips included the suggestion that she'd make a model wife. Bruce obviously...
The support. I'm Mark Goodman. On Friday in Austin, Texas, an all-star lineup of musicians gathered once again to help the American farmer. The occasion was Farm Aid 2, and MTV was there.
There's only 700 people in the town of Manor, Texas. Today, there's 50,000 plus.
God, it must have gotten up to at least 104 this afternoon.
I swear, we're a shovel full away from hell. We're that close.
Eating jalapenos in 100 degree heat, that's what we do.
I was walking miles on my hands and knees, and no doubt about it, baby, it's you I'm to be. We can go on together with suspicious minds.
I'm here at Farm Aid, for one thing, because it's the most American of these causes. And, you know, when we're asked to do things as often as we are, the one thing that we jump up for is to do things for home.
I knew that Farm Aid 1 had not done any great things. It hadn't solved any problems. The problem was still there, and there's farmers still going out of business in this country at the rate of one every 6 minutes. So whatever we're doing, it's obviously not enough.
In the last 3 or 4 years, nobody's made any money. Farmers can't make any money.
We have $17 billion for cost overrun for B-1 bomber. Should have had the money. We restructured these farmers that the most efficient farmers in all the world who fed America and who fed the world, they deserve a chance.
Farm Aid 2 went on for 18 hours with 80 artists performing. The show raised about $2 million. As John Cougar Mellencamp noted on stage, the farmers' problems continue.
And everybody knows that my main reason for being here is to bring the awareness of the American farmer to the people. And all I want to say tonight is that I think it's about time that we quit saying, the poor American farmer, I feel so bad about the American farmer. I think it's time that we stop these kind of things and let's get some action together and make something happen as opposed to, like, keep belaboring the problem, right?
Welcome back. I'm John Bon Jovi, and this is Richie Sambora. Together, we're bringing you a half hour of heavy metal thunder on Radio 1990.
Speaking of thunder, we've been working on our third album.
Why don't you tell them about it, John? Okay, the title of our third album, which is almost on your shelves, is called Slippery When Wet. The concept came in a go-go bar in Vancouver, Canada. It was produced by a new producer. His name is Bruce Fairburn. Hey, Bruce, what's happening? And we've finally been captured on vinyl, so just like caged animals, here we are, you know, bringing you the best of Bon Jovi.
Well, I'm sure there'll be a lot of great videos, but what's your favorite one to date?
Never dated a video before.
Well,
my favorite Bon Jovi video is In and Out of Love, because it was done on the Jersey Shore down at Seaside Heights in the height of the summer, which is right now, suntan weather, bikinis. So here it is, coming to you almost live, Bon Jovi, In and Out of Love. Radio 1990, we'll be back with Lisa Robinson's report on heavy metal, so stay tuned.
All right, headbangers.
Heavy metal has gone through a lot of changes since Steppenwolf put the term into the music back in 1968 with Born to Be Wild. Just look at us. Right now, here's Lisa Robinson with her thoughts on the current scene of heavy metal.
What's happened to
I wonder what Lisa thinks about us, man.
Oh, no.
We'll be right back with Hearing Aid, the heavy metal benefit for world hunger.
Crank up your TV sets for this one.
I need to read. I read good this time.
Last year, music got this bad rap when the Parents Music Resource Center tried to wrestle heavy metal to the mat.
Well, I'm glad that the lady bought our record just to check it out. You know?
One more record sale, even just to the senator's wife. Well, we fought back by being a part of Farm Aid 1 and probably 2. Ronnie James Dio, though, got tough by putting together a band called Hearing Aid.
Well, they recorded a song called Stars for the benefit of USA for Africa.
Hearing Aid features the talents of Ronnie James Dio, Rob Halford, Spinal Tap, Vince Neil, and choir leader Kevin Dubrow.
Must have been a good jam, huh?
Yeah. We'll be right back with more of Radio 1990, so don't you move.
Hi, well, I guess that's about all we have time for on Radio 1990's Heavy Metal Special. This is Bowie,
I'm Richie Sambora.
I'm John Bon Jovi. Catherine and Gary will be back tomorrow. But look for our new album, Slippery When Wet, and look for our summer tour. We'll be playing a beach town near you.
Judas Priest takes us out with Turbo Lover. Kind of a painful thought, like Roto-Rooter almost, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. It's from their album, Turbo, so say goodnight, Richie.
Yeah, goodnight, Richie.
Good night, Richie.
Good night, Richie.
The MTV Music News. Bon Jovi hoped that good advice on the highways equals good sales in the record stores. Therefore, their new album is called Slippery When Wet. The band are making the first video for the album right now, and John Bon Jovi told us more.
We're going to shoot our new video this week out in L.A., and it'll be to You Give Love a Bad Name. And right now, I've decided that any director who tells me concept and storyline, not talking to him. It's nothing but Bon Jovi. That's it. Live, live, live. So we're going to be shooting this week, and you know, you never know. We might direct it ourselves at this point.
Bon Jovi will kick off a North American tour next Monday night in Vancouver. The Beastie Boys, CB, the band, will say hello to America's Highway before then.
Tour starts July 14th. The album's not till August 1st. So we, you know, in the typical Bon Jovi style, are on the road. You know, before the album, we're already touring. Yeah, so we're out.
Having trouble with my Jovis there. The first single and video from Slippery When Wet is called You Give Love a Bad Name, and it'll be out at the end of July. It's Wednesday.
Our records, but it's real fun, it's real lively. The horns are on one. We have an acoustic ballad called Wanted Dead or Alive, which you know, I think is going to turn some heads too. So we're real excited about this one. You know, it should be real good for us.
Your ultimate.
Oh, geez, my ultimate.
19.
It's hot.
17.
16. And conceptual directors, beware. John Bon Jovi wants his videos live, live, live. I'm Alan Hunter in for my good buddy.
Good.
Number 12 from a band that played at both Farm Aids 1 and 2 on the request of Willie Nelson. That is Bon Jovi with You Give Love a Bad Name. Right next door on the count 13, You Give Love a Bad Name from Bon Jovi climbs to 12. And the number 11 position below
Jovi, our latest is just ahead on the MTV Top 20 Video Countdown.
On MTV.
Oh, Dove.
American album charts this week belongs to John Bon Jovi. The third album from Bon Jovi, Slippery When Wet, has become the first number one LP in their career, and it looks sure to go down as one of the biggest selling heavy rock albums of the year. What is it about their third album that's made it take off so fast? It could have something to do with the fact that they got some early advice on the record from their fans. When Bon Jovi were recording Slippery When Wet, they literally brought in people off the street to get their opinions. The band's manager, Doc McGee, said they had so many songs recorded, they decided to let the fans help decide which ones should go on the album, because after all, they're the people who are going to be buying it. Right now, they're buying it by the truckload. And the first video off the album makes another strong move on our chart, up from 7 to 4. It's Bon Jovi and You Give Love a Bad Name. This week's 4, You Give Love a Bad Name from Bon Jovi. Eddie Money coming in to three.
That's it.
Album Slippery When Wet, that's the world premiere of Bon Jovi's You Give Love a Bad Name. The video was directed by Wayne Isham, who's worked in the past with Dokken and Motley Crue. It was shot out in L.A. at the Olympic Auditorium, and one of the fire effects got a little out of control while they were shooting, setting the lighting rig on fire. So the producer of the video and an assistant had to come to the rescue, putting the blaze out. Let's get back.
Bon Jovi called You Give Love a Bad Name, and Bon Jovi getting ready to go out on the road with the band that started the hour, 38 Special. I'm Martha Quinn, and right...
Thank you.
go out on the road in Japan. Within 10 minutes, quintessential heavy metal band Bon Jovi, with a video called You Give Love a Bad Name. That's performance and nothing but performance.
Right now, I have decided that any director who tells me concept and storyline, I'm not talking to him. It's nothing but Bon Jovi. That's it. Live, live, live.
The bad name. That one was shot in the Olympic Auditorium in Los Angeles. And directed by Wayne Isham, who's done videos for Dokken and Judas Priest. Now, this is kind of weird, but during the shoot, they had mud wrestlers on the set to relieve the tension and amuse the band between takes. I don't know, guys.
The Week in Rock.
Let's start the week at the top with Bon Jovi. Their Slippery When Wet became the fourth heavy metal album ever to make it to Billboard's number one.
The album went to number one because you called up and requested the video, and you went out and bought the record, and you called up your local radio station and bugged the hell out of them.
Yeah.
And we thank you.
Here's another truth.
Inside heavy metal. Now, heavy metal has got not only loud rock and roll and a, you know, twang guitar. I guess twanging is the wrong word when you talk about heavy metal, where you say crunching guitars and strong backbeats, but they also have a lot of hairspray and, interestingly enough, a lot of makeup. And we're going to take a look here at the long legacy of big hair and painted faces in the wild world of loud rock and roll.
What do you think of when you think of heavy metal? Guitars, girls in spandex, boys in denim, big amps, big drums, big arenas, big hits. Well, we're forgetting about two simple things. Where would heavy metal be without big hair and makeup?
Yes. The motley hat mold, as we call it.
My favorite thing about makeup, people walk up to me and say, you look better without it. I say, I hope so.
A person's look never changes how they sound. So, but if you feel a certain way, then you sort of exemplify that in the way you dress.
From Kiss to Bon Jovi, from Alice Cooper to Motley Crue, what you put on your face can be as important as what you put on your vinyl.
The way we look, the way we dress, and our sound is all an icing on the attitude. It all stems from the same thing, so it's all relative in the first place.
We've always tended towards more the glam than the heavy metal, than because to us, heavy metal leans more on the punk side.
I think a look of a band is important to any band, you know, I mean, again, going back to the idea of, say, our first album where you got something like just Bon Jovi, and the way I played down the looks of the band because I didn't want to be pegged as a pretty boy band.
A lot of people say, well, this is a glam band, and we're a glamorous rock and roll band is what we are. We like to dress up and for the audience.
But sometimes your rouge might rub somebody the wrong way.
I got arrested once with a full face of makeup on. In the middle of the night in some hick town in upstate New York, and I spent the night in jail with a full face of makeup. And I think you can imagine, the cops had a field day. Let's face it, folks, I was in a lot of trouble.
Next up,
and a number one video. Well, the band in our top spot has had both, and we'll hear from their main man after one more look at this week's top ten. It is the first number one video for Bon Jovi, who just last week scored their first number one album, Slippery When Wet. Well, now that Bon Jovi knows the secret of hitting number one, can he repeat it? It's not that easy. The only real secret is there's no secret.
If I could bottle it, I would sell it, you know, and we'd all make $1 million, you know what I mean? But we're songwriters, and you don't know as a songwriter why something works and why something doesn't work. You know, it's really too hard to guess.
Well, even if there's no magic formula, the magic has worked for them this time. New Jersey Metal has made it to the top. Our new number one, You Give Love a Bad Name, from Bon Jovi. Right after a quick recap of the record. Holding on to MTV's number one spot for a second week, it is Bon Jovi. Now, if you are one of the more than a million people who have bought a copy of the Slippery When Wet LP, you'll be happy to know the Parents Music Resource Center was looking out for you.
PMRC came down on us a bit because in the beginning we wanted the album cover to be this bodacious woman that we found on the beach in Jersey, Angela. And she was the cover in a t-shirt that says Slippery When Wet, but PMRC went,
So we couldn't do it. So what we did was gave him a hefty bag. Black hefty bag of water on it, and John, his two fingers went slippery when wet, and we went art.
But it was just like this. He says, well, put out the cover you want, and there is about 800 stores that will follow. And I said, 800? And they said, 800. Just imagine if each one of them only sold 1,000 albums, but 800,000 albums, you know. I said, no. I'm not an artist. I'm, you know, a songwriter. And let's get the music out on the street.
Right. The cover's not important.
So we didn't care about the cover.
Well, whether it's Angela's chest or a wet hefty bag, the album still got our number one video for the second straight week. Bon Jovi's You Give Love a Bad Name. And growing up, like a lot of other teenagers around America, Don...
It's not really a part of what we do. We're, you know, more like, you know, the makeup band, you know, or whatever you want to call them, are doing. I picture more of what I'm doing as like Clint Eastwood with a guitar. You know, so it's, you know, the attitude taken here is very much that, you know, I got a holster, but it's got my microphone in it, you know, so image conscious, it's very street, it's just, it's truly us.
Go ahead, John, make our day with this week's number 7 video, up two places.
Well, it would be silly to say a prayer. It is the second clip from their smash album, Slippery When Wet, and the director is Wayne Isham, who also shot You Give Love a Bad Name. John Bon Jovi and his guitarist, Richie Sambora, told us more.
Pretty much decided that he liked our idea for the first one, and we used it on the second one. And it involves a little more of the idea of us fooling around and then playing with the audience.
Yeah, there's some staging stuff and some technical stuff involving the film that'll make this one different than Bad Name, so people won't, it's not a continuation, you know. So.
Well, this is a metal music half hour.
Also hold their ground. This band's current album was the victim of censorship a few months back, and we're going to hear why they gave in to that censorship right after a quick recap. Holding on to MTV's number one spot for a second week, it is Bon Jovi. Now, if you are one of the more than a million people who have bought a copy of the Slippery When Wet LP, you'll be happy to know the Parents Music Resource Center was looking out for you.
PMRC came down on us a bit because in the beginning we wanted the album cover to be this bodacious woman that we found on the beach in Jersey, Angela. And she was the cover in a t-shirt that says Slippery When Wet, but PMRC went, So we couldn't do it. So what we did was gave him a hefty bag, black hefty bag of water on it, and John, his two fingers went, Slippery When Wet, and we went, art.
But it was just like this. He says, well, put out the cover you want, and there is about 800 stores that will follow. And I said, 800? And they said, 800. Just imagine if each one of them only sold 1,000 albums, but 800,000 albums, you know. I said, no. I'm not an artist. I'm, you know, a songwriter. And let's get the music out on the street.
Right. The cover's not important.
So we didn't care about the cover.
Well, whether it's Angela's chest or a wet hefty bag, the album still got our number one video for the second straight week. Bon Jovi's You Give Love a Bad Name. Had a three-week number one since August until Bon Jovi did it last week. But they're neck and neck with Genesis, and only one video can be number one.
20, 19, ching, 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 ching. 17, 16, 12, 10.
Thanks a lot, guys.
7, 6.
Through the barricade. A new number one video is on the way this week, since right now at number two, it's last week's number one from Bon Jovi. Now, John Bon Jovi has never been overly fashion conscious, but he does get into some wild clothes on stage, like the pair of black and red pants that he's wearing in the video. They're actually secondhand pants that John stumbled across while paying a visit to a fancy L.A. clothing designer.
I was looking through these two racks, and I says, what are these racks? He says, well, these are the clothes that people have sent back, or my junk rack. And I came across those pants in the Bad Name video, and I yanked them out. I said, whose are these?
And he goes, oh, those, they belong to Earth, Wind, and Fire about 15 years ago. And I went, 15 years ago, I'll take them. And then he goes, well, okay. And then he wants to, like, play with the price. I said, I'll give you 10 bucks for them. And he made a couple alterations and gave them to me for 10 bucks. Good deal, huh?
Well, I guess maybe if Maurice White or anybody else in Earth, Wind, and Fire is watching, perhaps they'll recognize those old pants. Slipping to number two this week, if you give love a bad name, from Bon Jovi.
Jersey, who act like five guys from New Jersey. We asked John Bon Jovi why Bad Name was a good song to get him to the top.
I don't know. Bad Name seems to have a catchy chorus or something. I mean, to sit here and second guess everything for you is like you pick me at a bad time, you know? If I could bottle it, I would sell it, you know, and we'd all make $1 million, you know what I mean? But we're songwriters, and you don't know as a songwriter why something works and why something doesn't work.
Bon Jovi's next single and video will be Living on a Prayer. Here are some dates for them live. Incidentally, Living on a Prayer will be in stores December 8th, and those concert date information spots...